A mere quick look at all that's happening here on the floor offers few clues to the exact products FMI manufactures. It's a long and assorted list, but the common foundation is the company's extremely high temperature resistant, lightweight composites.
And it can withstand upwards of 5,000 degrees Fahrenheit on one side, and 3 inches away it'll be 80 degrees Fahrenheit.
Well, it's light.
And very light, yeah.
Launched in 1969, for decades, FMI essentially flew under the radar. Most of its work top secret, including building heat shields for U.S. government missile defense systems. But today, the company's vision is more global.
We're really trying to diversify the business and reach into new markets and get away from just 100% pure defense business and focus on markets where are more commercial in nature.
It's no stretch to say this company is going places, even as far as Mars. Among its success stories, FMI built the heat shield which helped land the Mars rover in 2012 and is currently building the next generation shield for a Mars mission in 2020, which could also include a human crew.
And as it enters the atmosphere, our heat shield will slow the vehicle down just by the pressure in the atmosphere and also protect the vehicle from the high temperatures that it'll see traveling at in excess of 25,000 miles per hour.
Touting its composites as stronger but not nearly as heavy as most metals.
And this material has a much lighter weight and compares in strength to some exotic metals such as titanium.
Essentially the same materials the company used to build those highly classified missile components are now going into public ventures.
Formula One race cars, it can be used in components for actually top fuel drag racing engines. We've done prosthetic knees and ankles and replacing titaniums.
No longer the covert operation, today FMI's gates are wide open. And with more products, it needs more people.
We're growing the business. It's growing at a very rapid rate, and we're working diligently to fill a bunch of openings that we have today.
And FMI's diversity into new international markets caught the attention of the organization Maine International Trade Center, which just last week named it Innovator of the Year.